Okay, Toby Flood, new Leicester captain. There's been some decent captains in the past at Leicester, so that's the first thing you've got to live up to. And the second thing is, you're defending champions, and it's not easy, is it, to win, let alone defend?
No, it's not. It's not ideal. It's not ideal in the sense that the people want to take the crown away when you arrive at the town. But Leicester are used to that. I think they understand the connotations of that. For 9 years, they've been finalists, and throughout that, they've had people that come up to them and want to take them away. And as I know, having played at Newcastle, Leicester's a big game, and you want to win that game, and the crowd comes in, and the players raise their level. So we're used to that environment. And as you say, the captaincy on the other side, we've got a fantastic squad, guys that look after themselves and manage themselves tremendously well. And for me, you know, it's basically, it's walking out front, it's saying a couple of words, because you know the expectation level and the levels these guys drive themselves to in training is really high, and you just have to manage that.
The thing that the media and the rugby public always learn is that one way or another, Leicester always seems to be there or thereabouts at the business end of the season. The one thing that they never learn is that after three or four defeats before Christmas, it's always a crisis at Leicester. I guess it'll be the same again this season.
Yeah, well, let's hope we don't lose too many before Christmas. But yeah, I think we have the ability, or certainly the team historically has had the ability to be there or thereabouts, always throw the hat into the ring. And that's all that really matters. I mean, you want to be in the top four, and if you're in the top four, you give yourself a chance. So that's, you know, we never set goals, we just go about our business the way we go about our business. We don't even set goals in-house. It's just about being good blokes, working hard, and seeing where that gets. As you say, we lose a couple of games before Christmas in the autumn period, or in the first couple of games of the season. We'll manage that, we'll deal with that. But you know, that's the situation we're in. We expect to be there and thereabouts every day of the week. We expect to be 100% every training session. And if we get that right, then normally we're in the right part of the year.
Traditionally, it's quite tough after a Lions year, as you know. You've had six visiting Lions in the Leicester team. Is that going to pose problems, or should be okay?
We don't know the truth of it. As you say, you know, tradition states that this is what happens, but out of those six Lions we've had, five of them are homegrown. Guys that come through the academy know what it means to be a Leicester bloke, what the expectation levels are of them. Again, why my job is so easy, or job in inverted commas. And because of that, I think, you know, it shouldn't be as difficult as maybe people perceive. We don't know, truthfully. They might play four games of the season, put their hand up in the air and say, I'm absolutely knackered and I need some time away. That might happen. I've had their 4 weeks, like everybody else. They seem ready and raring to go. A few guys getting brought back in nice and slowly, doing less work, obviously, because of their bodies. And we'll see, you know, how they go first couple of games of the season.
Now, obviously, England, it all depends on how you do with the club, especially this time of the year, isn't it? There's a few weeks, a few games before anybody can start worrying about England. I was going to say the 10 jersey, it's competitive. Was ever to us, wasn't it? But certainly with Owen Farrell, with Freddie Burns, with yourself, good for England, but highly competitive for you.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think it's always been quite a competitive position, you know. And I think that obviously Owen's come on the last couple of years, Freddie's been playing well the last year or so. But it's like every position, you look at Chris Robshaw, you look at the back row, second row is pretty good at the moment. Dave Atwood had an outstanding finish in the year, which is where you want England to be. And I know it's not super, but as long as you're in an environment where there's a successful environment, guys are playing well. You want that sort of cut thrust and that real sort of necessity to be involved in the side that is driving each other's standards, and that's where we probably are at the moment. And the nice thing is, Stu's trying to create an ethos where it's no one's shirt, it's a shirt hanging on the wall, and every time you're there, you're fighting for it.
Now, I know the league's massively important to you. You're proud defending champions. But this year, as every year, you'll be setting your sights on the Heineken Cup as well. You have no given right to win the Heineken Cup, but you have done it twice. And for a team like Leicester, it's long overdue.
Yeah, I think we went to Toulon last year, and it was a pretty tight game. And to lose by 6 points there against the Glitterati that is and the quality they had, you know, that was tough. We really struggled with that. I think mentally that was a big game for us to lose. And to sort of think that we could have gone there and won, and as you say, Quinn's got to quarterfinal home, probably should have gone through, and Saracens has made that semi-final, and I think the English team's gave themselves a decent showing last year. But for us, it's always on our radar, undoubtedly. We want to come out of our group top, which we did in a really tough group last year, and to be able to put yourself in that sort of home quarterfinal place is imperative. It's certainly a target for us. We want to be there and thereabouts, but like anything, it doesn't come. The group stage doesn't finish until January or February, so we know there's a long way to go in the season. And as long as most of our guys are fit, we'll give it a crack.
Okay, have a great season.
Cheers, man. Thank you.